So my Kingston SSD disk just died. It's time to throw this and look for a new one. While looking for my new replacement PCIe M.2 NVMe SSD disk, and with the bad experience from Kingston, I had only two options, keeping in mind reliability and speed, Samsung and WD. So I finally went for the 250GB version, the WD Blue SN570 M.2 NVMe SSD. This WD Blue is essentially a mid-range DRAM-less solid-state drive, which makes it cheap, but being a PCI Express-based device, it can get all the juice it needs through PCIe interface. There are other awesome features that we will discuss in this video. Just to remind you, this video is not at all being sponsored. Let's unbox this NVMe solid state drive. Western Digital manufactures internal storage for more than 4 different categories: the green, blue, black and red. Green one is entry level and is meant for daily use. The blue family is for power users such as creators like me. The WD Black, which is high performance for gamers. Then finally, the red one, which is for network attached storage systems. The speeding performance of the disk are very good, having a competitive price tag with up to 3300 megabytes per second for read and 1200 megabytes per second for write. The SN570 uses a SanDisk controller paired with the latest 112-layer 3D TLC flash from Toshiba, also known as BICS5. DRAM cache is not available to reduce manufacturing cost. Let's install WD SN570 into M.2 PCI Express slot of the Gigabyte H510M motherboard. After turning on the PC or laptop, go to BIOS and confirm if the SSD disk is visible. There we can see the disk is showing up in the BIOS. After that, I boot my PC into Windows setup and initialize the disk by creating new partitions from a bootable USB disk and then continue installing Windows 10. Upon booting into your PC or laptop, the drivers are going to automatically install for you, so don't need to worry about it. The great thing about Western Digital is its software support. You need to download it from their website by entering the exact model of your SSD. Once the software is installed, you can monitor the health and performance of your disk drive. Also, if your SSD is having any problems, you can download updated firmware or perform tests to check for any problems. The best thing about purchasing WD internal storage is that you get 1 month membership for Adobe Creative Cloud and also Acronis TrueImage, the award-winning files backup software. You can redeem this software once you download WD Dashboard and activate it immediately upon filling up a online form. So we tested the temperature on WD Blue SN570 and on idle it was a good 29 degrees Celsius. But right after copying huge amount of game files, the temperature started to exceed 55 degrees Celsius. Do you really need a heatsink radiator for your NVMe SSD? Well, yes. And we will do that in our next video. Here are some benchmarking results for this SSD performed on AS SSD and Crystalmark Disk Info. And you can clearly see it beats my previous Kingston, a 2000 PCI Express NVMe SSD. Overall, my ratings for this NVMe SSD is an insane price per performance and reliability. That's it for now. Thank you for watching.